Japan in September 2008, which worked on a conference on critical issues for Japan's future. And the second day I was there, I flew over from Santa Barbara here, and I had a respiratory infection, and I almost about canceled my trip. Because I was, for Cameo, who just called, and went and brought me to this lovely place on top of a very elegant Japanese hotel, and Master Rendo Sugimoto showed up with two of the people that worked with him. I had no idea who he was, no idea of his background, anything else. And he was sitting across the table from me and looking at me very intently and everything else. And at the moment, all of a sudden he got up, he walked around, and I sat and wondered what he was doing. He put one hand on my chest and one hand on my back, and the next thing I felt like it was a fire inside of me. That was the end of the respiratory infection. And I've had quite a lot of experience with healers and complementary medicine. I realized this is the hand of a real incredible master. And since then, Rendo is regarded in Japan as the master traditional healer of Japan. He's highly supported by the Japanese government and tours and gives lectures extensively up to Japan and also in other parts of the Far East. And we've been fortunate to have him here at Santa Barbara.
Integrating something that comes from ancient Japan, the indigenous religion of Japan, Yoga, which integrated with Japanese form of Buddhism in the 17th century. And that integration with his own knowledge, through his own experiences with healing, have revolved now around an ability to enable him to heal people very effectively by combining these various highly philosophies and healing aspects that come from both Japan and basically, it has to do with the fact that he very fortuitously for us happened to have been raised and now resides on the Izu Peninsula of Japan, a place that my wife and I visited, and is fantastic, with remarkable amounts of healing hot springs that they have in that particular area. But since they, during that time period, understanding how healing occurs for him, has integrated the accepted yogi philosophy of healing with these healing hot springs, and called the Amagi Therapy. Amagi standing for the Amagi Mountains, which are the Izu Peninsula. So I think we're in for, and here we are, so we'll see today, with Sensei talking about, I think maybe demonstrating how he heals people.
I should make one mention. He's also the only French trained pastry chef that's also a healer in the world.
The most important thing in the, even the Buddhism is also healing process. What we need to start doing at the beginning, starting conversation, having dialogue with them, which is like a mind and a body, and start talking to our own body to really understand
all of them. で、2番目に出るのは顔面です。はい、顔面と手のひら、足の裏です。
Okay, what he is saying, what sign is something of balance, some kind of physical problem, showing from the back. That the first step, what sign we can notice.The second is sign showing from the face, the balance of the face, then extended to the hand, palm, and also the feet.
だから我々は顔を見て、一人一人の顔を見てどこどこがあるか。
Like a master, like him, actually, he can pay attention to your face, then he has an instinct to figure out what kind of problem you have.
まあ、彼女の場合は、ここの、例えばここの、入れてるで、ここの部分は、人形で、これが
For example, he find already the kidney problem by seeing her face by seeing a chick. He had a scar on his right leg because of he fell from sky. Because of his medical doctor gave up on him, but he didn't want to give up his own health. So he started researching and studying. He feel you are also lack of chewing too.
You chew when you have time?
You have a very stiff throat that by observing you. Then he also finds out that you are not.